press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update. Three things together comes under the picture of the Cognizant Tree branch. Yes. When I came to know that that CTS, the technological side, is just 17% of the entire organization. I went there. I told her I just simply kept my CV in my file, and she was like, "Hi, how are you?" I was like, "I was absolutely fine." And then she's like.
Okay, so hi everyone, welcome to the Real Humans of B School. Today we have with us here Soham, who is joining us from US. It's like super cold out there and we are troubling him early in the morning just to make sure you guys get to know some amazing experience of Soham, who's an alum from OP Jindal Global Business School and working with Salesforce. So welcome on board, Soham.
Thank you for that, and good morning to you.
Yes, good morning to you. So tell me, how's the weather like in US?
It's actually pretty bit cold. I'm in Connecticut now. And I can say in Indian centigrade, because these people talk about like Fahrenheit. But if I talk about, Celsius, it's in minus six now. So you can understand that it's pretty bit cold here. So yeah,
it's minus six. I'm sure we would be loaded with like six layers of clothes out there to beat that -6 degrees.
True.
And that's amazing. Great. So tell me, you are currently working with Salesforce. So what do you do?
Right. I work as a marketing as well as a business analyst. So because my background belongs to marketing, but marketing also requires to know the knowledge of the business. So that's why what happened is that whenever we talk about, the business, the finance, the HR and everything relates to a combination of how do you market anything, right? Yeah. So there it's the analysis or the analyst comes into the picture. Which is us actually. So I mean, going good. And background is, because it's marketing, so it's helping me actually.
Lovely. So you did marketing in your MBA. Well, how about the background before that? What have you done before that?
Right. So I'm an engineer. I'm an electrical engineer. Once I did my electrical engineering, I then started working with Cognizant as a software developer. Then I thought of like, okay, fine. Because I was in software industry, the life was a bit of monotonous. So I thought of like doing again something into my electrical engineering. So I gave an exam for Ministry of Power, and I got into that with the scholarship. So I did my postgrad diploma under transmission and distribution in power system under Ministry of Power, which is in Delhi. And before coming to the business background or doing my MBA, so this is what I did. I mean,
lovely. That's pretty interesting. I think a lot of people here are going to resonate with you. We have all electrical, electronics, mechanical engineers who get into the rut of working in software companies. I worked with Infosys. I was a software engineer who worked in did computers and then moved to Infosys, but that's what we all are, and we want to get rid of the whole fact because it gets so monotonous. I'm pretty sure all the people are relating to us. So yeah, it's pretty interesting. You did your master's from Ministry of Power in electrical again. Then what made you think that I want to do an MBA?
Right. So what happened is, let me tell you just a small background story for that. So while I was working in Cognizant, Because Cognizant has three parts of it on its own. Cognizant has CBC, which is Cognizant Business Consultancy, which is CTS, where I was working, the technological side, and another side is the BPO and KPO side. Now, all the three things together comes under the picture of the Cognizant tree branch. Yes. When I came to know that CTS, the technological side, is just 17% of the entire organization, and that CBC holds actually more than 70% of it. So when I came to know that business is the main, you can work as a developer, you can work as, you know, and as an analyst and everything, but unless and until you do have your business, nothing will comes into your picture for your organization. You can't grow. So, you know, since that time it came into my mind, but I was not exactly channelized myself in a particular way that I can go ahead and do my MBA in some field, whether it's an HR, finance, or marketing. It did not came into my mind at that time. But afterwards, I thought that MBA is the only way for me to understand a business. If someday, after working for a certain period of time, if I understand that I can open up my own business, I need to understand what is actually the core of it. And that's where MBA came into the picture.
Absolutely. That's absolutely very essential. I mean, you know, it's like, in any organization, as long as you're the one who's bringing business, you are growing, you are important. Otherwise, you are like one amongst 1,001 people out there.
Right. Very true.
Interesting. Great. So, you know, Soham, you like have done such diverse things. You worked in Cognizant, you worked with electrical field, which is there. So when you say, you know, you've come into Salesforce, that too in US and Connecticut, what do you think? How were you able to grab that?
Right. So in US, there is a saying goes, actually. So I will start by that since the day I have joined, UT Dallas here for my master's. So the saying goes that whoever comes outside of the country, the first thing they have to do from the day one is networking, networking, and networking. That's all.
True.
So what you have to do is you have to connect with, you don't have to, search for the organization. You have to connect to the people of the organization.
Correct.
Also, a particular people who can help you to grow. Not only to, you know, I mean, just to like text you or just to let you know, hey, you know what, there is a job opportunity. Can you grab hold of something? Or you are texting somebody, hey, you know what, I'm available in the market. You know, I'm doing this. Is there any possibility? No, it's not like that. Making a relationship with anybody in this networking world, it's very important. Yeah. I still remember, you know, that the first internship which I got. So, actually, Xfinity, Comcast, it's been known here as the United States, one of the biggest cable as well as internet company, where I did my marketing internship. Okay. So how do I get it? I mean, how do I get that? It's a beautiful story. So we were all, and here in US, there is nothing called campus placement happens. There's only job fair. And in that job fair, you can stand in a queue, I mean, in hundreds of lines. You can give your CV to them. They will check. They will let you know, hey, you know what? You got it. You don't. That's all. That's all happens. There's nothing called campus placement and 17 students are sitting for that. I mean, like for marketing and 18 students are sitting for the finance. Nothing happens here. Everything depends on your marketing. Now, what happened is in our job fair, when we were standing in hundreds of queue, I saw that 10 people are exactly giving the same sort of format for the same CV. To the HR of to the HR of another company.
Okay.
When I saw her that, you know, she's, I mean, and everybody is almost, you know, talking about same thing. Hey, you know what? I did that. And it's so nice to meet you. And, you know, hopefully to have a call with you someday. And that's all. When I was the 10th person, I thought of not repeating the same words and not giving the same CV because it's the same format. And exactly few words will be changed and that's all. What I did, I went there, I told her I just simply kept my CV in my file. And she was like, hi, how are you? I was like, I was absolutely fine. And then she's like, aren't you gonna supposed to hand over your CV to me? I was like, yes, definitely. But before that, I will request you one thing. you have talked to 9 people before me. You did not have a second to catch your breath. How about I walk with you? We can have a glass of water and we can talk there.
Interesting. That's pretty interesting.
What she did, she literally went with me. She and someone else was handling the booth at the time for that particular company. Let me tell you that that company is Hyatt, the Hyatt Hotel. They came for the marketing sector. So I went with her, and then we were standing. So she's like, interesting. So that you didn't, hand over your CV first. I was like, ma'am, let me tell you one thing. I'm 100% sure that I am not the first student you have talked in your entire career. Also, I'm not the first student from UT Dallas you have talked for, in this day for the very first time. And it's not for you the first time that you came to UT Dallas. You saw this CV thousands of times. So let us talk about something interesting about me rather than giving you the CV. I can give you the CV after that if you like. We have talked for 2 minutes. She went back, and it's our customary that in our LinkedIn, we literally search them and we just give them a thank you note that thank you very much for coming to our university. And that's all. I send her a thank you note. She literally replied me after 5 minutes that, Soham, I do remember you. You are the guy who has offered me water. She had recommended me her friend who is the senior director of the HR in Xfinity. And I got my internship.
Lovely. That's like called true networking. And I think that's what B school teaches you all about, that you learn for it.
Exactly.
Amazing. That's so amazing, which is there. Now tell me about this. Like, you said you did your master's when you entered in UT Dallas, but right. If I remember, you also did your MBA from OP General. So do you get this opportunity to do 1 year here and 1 year there?
Yes, correct. Absolutely. So if it would not have been for OP General, I might have, it would have been like linger, not like I would have got that opportunity at that time. But I every time I wake up in the morning, because I'm in US now. So every day I wake up, I sit for my job. I thank for the first person is God. And the second is OP Jindal, just because of this reason, because, they have given us an opportunity that you can grow. That's the first, that's their first motto. You can grow with others. Okay. So yes, and it was a beautiful journey for me also with my friends, with my faculties in OP Jindal. If I start talking about my faculties, I cannot even stop, because they have helped you grow in every way. Also, not only our faculties, the people who are behind us 24/7, that student, you have to do it. You have to get it done. And that's what his MBA is all about. MBA gives you pressure so that once you come out of the, come out of the institution, once you join the original, you come to the corporate world, you should not break yourself.
Correct.
That's the make or break point.
That's very true. I think that's what people should realize, that MBA is not going to be a piece of cake. It's going to be stressful. It's going to be hectic, but it's worth the whole drill.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Lovely. So you mentioned about the factor, like the faculties and everything, and they contribute a lot to the whole training and, the whole curriculum. Tell me, how about the peers? Like, you have studied for a year in India and a year in US. How different is it to have this combination of multicultural diversity?
Right. So when we are in India, what we try to do is, we try to gather all our knowledge so that we can, whatever subject we study, irrespective of any field, let's suppose, because we belong to the MBA and the MS group. So let's talk about the MBA group then. So in the MBA, when we study about for the first year, it's very important, because the second year comes to your specialization, and that specialization only will come into your mind unless and until you will come to know in the first year for all the knowledges, whether it belongs to marketing, finance, HR, business analytics, anything. So first year is pretty much important, where you can, you have to study in depth. You have to read books. That's the most important part. Whether it's for finance, you have to understand the concept, so that in the second year, when you come, and if you come to a, if you get this beautiful opportunity to come to at least this country, you have to understand that once you come here, it will be a piece of cake for you. Because, you know, these people, they study less. They don't study like us. I mean, they don't study in depth like us, but they do believe in the practical applications. But your practical application and the implementation only will come if you have the knowledge, and that knowledge will come from the first year. Whether it belongs to the economics, whether it belongs to your marketing chapter, whether it belongs to something related to finance, something related to HR, every knowledge you have in your first year, which is very important. And that's what the main matters. And for, I mean, for like, you know, especially a college like OP Jindal, where, you know, professors will tell you that this is what is trend is going on. You can read the book, but if the trend is unknown to you, you cannot catch up with the speed of this world. So just do that. And it's really helpful. Trust me. So yeah.
Lovely. So if you were to tell me, like, you know, this is pretty interesting. Did you ever feel like coming to US after that, you know, I think I am well more read and more knowledgeable than all of the other guys out here because they don't really go through that drill and pressure like we do.
Yes, and yes, sort of like that. Yes. So let me tell you that once I started doing my master's here, the first two subjects, I mean, in my first semester, the first two subjects were statistics and marketing management. I was like, and literally they have a, I mean, it's a similar, like they have a gradation of A and everything. So when I started doing my class for the statistics, I was like, seriously, I have to do this. And people are like, oh my God. I was like, oh, so this is what we have to do it. And I was just simply looking at them because at that time, statistics was like nothing for us. We did business mathematics. We did statistics. You know, our professors, I mean, taught us like so well. And it's actually, I can visualize everything.
Wow.
I did not have to study for that. So, you know, these things happen. So once you come here and then you can choose your own subjects according to your own, your own field.
Okay.
But the thing is that you will always connect back to the MBA first year because you read everything.
True. Absolutely true. Absolutely true. So if I were to ask you one thing, Soham, like, you know, what made you choose that my interest is marketing? Since you are an engineer, you know, like it takes time to decide and what marketing is my passion area.
Right. Correct. So the first thing came into my mind that I always love to talk. That's the thing.
Okay.
The second thing is I always love to connect with people. Mm-hmm. And business and marketing is all about people and customer.
Correct.
If you have your customer, you can grow. Amazon has grown like quite a fold in front of all our eyes. We never even understood that how. We have platform like, because it's once you come to US, we have Walmart, we have Amazon. We have some other things also who are like billion-dollar industry, but why Amazon? That's the question, because it deals more efficient way with customer, with people, right? So that's came into my mind and that's the like a make or break point for me that, okay, marketing is the place or marketing is the portion where I can reach the core center of the people. I can understand from their perspective because, you know, whatever product nowadays it comes into the market, it is not about organizational based. It's not about product based. Everything is about customer based.
Correct.
If customer does not like you, you will fail.
Yes.
So marketing is the place, I can say it's a bridge between the organization and the people.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Lovely. That's an amazing piece of advice. So one last thing I would want to say is like, you know, what would you give as an advice to all the people who are preparing for their interviews to get into colleges like Jindal or preparing to, you know, get themselves geared up to get and bag an offer something like Salesforce in life?
Right. No, actually, thank you for that. But I cannot just emphasize in one thing. But one thing I can tell you that having the world knowledge, because you will be, trust me, after 2 years of your college, I mean, you know, a college, especially like a multi-purpose college like Jindal, I would suggest you that if you are in Jindal, take the most advantage of your life of reading, learning from the multicultural purpose. because that's one of the versatile college in the entire country. Because trust me, I had been to IIT also. I have done my project in IIT. I have done my project in IIM also. So I know that IIT, it's only technology. IIM is only business. They do not talk about anything. But Jindal is one of the colleges in our entire country which talks about everything. You can learn everything. Okay, you can learn like all the multipurpose and you can learn about the world. Learning about the new trends, learning about your own self, and the most important part is to how to communicate with people. Because you cannot sit, I mean, you cannot sit at a meeting or an interview by wearing something else.
True.
I mean, you have to communicate with every people in their own way. You cannot, you know, sit in front of interviewer and you can say, hey, how are you doing? You cannot say that.
Correct.
So prepare yourself for this, for the most amazing trends in the world. And also try not to repeat what you have written in your resume because they already can see that. You don't have to repeat those words. Because if you repeat, okay, fine. If I tell you, hey, you know what? I'm working for Salesforce as a business analyst. I'm doing that. You can read that. I don't have to tell you that.
True.
What you can say is just to stand out from the crowd. It's just wearing a yellow helmet, like which Amir Khan, you know, actually wore in PK.
Yeah.
He told that yellow can be visible from other globe also, right? Mm-hmm. From above. So it's the same thing which you have to do. You have to tell some interesting story or an example which relates to your own project or whatever you have done, whichever study you have done. If you're an engineer, definitely you did some of the project in your final year, maybe throughout the year, maybe throughout your 4 years. Talk about that. Talk something interesting to them. It does not matter that you have to be experienced before you get a job after you do your MBA. It does not matter. What matters is how you sell yourself. So it all comes to the Wolf of the Wall Street, sell me the pen. That's all.
Lovely. Lovely. That's so amazing. That's so true. I think, you know, Soham, I can totally relate to all the aspects which you have spoken, that it's all at the end of it about how well-read you are, how well knowledgeable you are, and how well can you communicate that in the interviews to the panel. That's what you are doing. You're selling yourself out there. So thank you so much, Soham, for sharing your time with us and sharing such amazing insights. I'm sure it's going to be really helpful for all the people who are aspiring to get into Jindal and the other B schools out there. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you.